the street, they call it murder.
Welcome to another edition of What's Seen. I'm your host, Glacio. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo recently visited Jamaica. So we're here to ask persons how they feel about Prime Minister Andrew Holness hosting the Secretary of State here in Jamaica.
Well, I'm not feeling pleased about it still. Because I'm not a fan of Trump. Well, and it's true, I'm not a fan. Because the one thing I don't like, I'm dealing with the situation of court with everything. So I don't really, that's not my cup of tea.
It's a great idea, as long as he incorporates the rest of the Caribbean islands, because united we stand and divided we fall.
I think it's not a good thing, because they've never been here before for like serious matters, so I don't know why they're here now.
I think Jamaica has a lot of ties to the United States, and I wouldn't say they have a lot of control over decisions that the US makes in terms of wanting to have an ally in Jamaica. I think they already do. So I think Andrew is probably just going with the motion to keep the US happy. I don't know how much control we have over decisions made by the US and how much influence Jamaica has over any decision made by the US and in the region.
I don't really know anything about this person that you're talking about, but for one, third world countries always get defensive when it comes on to anything to do with America because of the fact that they look down on third world countries. Second of all, they are known to be the egg cooker and bucket washer and the devil worshipping. So therefore, people who know God is afraid to affiliate or associate themselves with America, period.
So I think it's a proper visit. Should see Jamaica benefiting from the United States. America and not just saying that they're going to help us in any way, but to show economic benefits, immigration benefits, and all those benefits should come in place.
Jamaica has always maintained a good relationship with the United States, and we've also maintained a good relationship with CARICOM. Now, the fact is that Mr. Holness must have evaluated the pros and cons before doing so, and his decision to do so I think was a good one, because it's always good to listen to what someone else has to say. But after the meeting and after everything is discussed, then he has to weigh everything that has been put in front of him and make sure that he's making a good decision or good decisions, and that whatever decisions he's making is not going to be considered a betrayal to CARICOM. But I don't think there's anything wrong with listening to what they have to say.
Well, I don't think it's a good reason for him host it here, because all of the other CARICOM against it. So I mean, I feel like it's a good reason now at the time. And I'm only want to use the country too. That's all.
There you have it, guys. While some have lauded Prime Minister Andrew Holness for hosting Pompeo, others are skeptical about America's true intentions in Jamaica.